Hello children, welcome to biology class. So today we are continuing the same lesson, strategies for enhancement in food production. In last class we had discussed about animal husbandry, cattle farming techniques, poultry farming techniques and different aspects of animal breeding technique, isn't it? Today we are continuing the same concept, animal husbandry, and we will discuss apiculture and fisheries today. So we can start with apiculture. What is apiculture? I know you are familiar with this. Yes, beekeeping. It is a maintenance of hives of honeybees for the production of honey. Isn't it? So, why we have to produce honey? What are their importance? Yes, it is an important food item. So, it is a food of high nutritive value and also find use an indigenous system of medicine. Okay, so let's check the medicinal values of honey. It boosts the memory, it heals a wound, it soothes the sore throat and cough, it heals peptic ulcers, it treats seasonal allergies, it heals psoriasis and also beats insomnia. What is insomnia? It is sleep disorder. Okay, so these are the medicinal value of honey. Not only honey, the bee wax is also an important byproduct. So that we can also produce beeswax, and beeswax is also having a lot of commercial value. So it is used for the preparation of ointments, plasters, polishes, and for the manufacture of candle, and for preparing different molds, and for dental and electronic industries, and used in cosmetics for the preparation of lipsticks and face creams. Pharmaceutically, it is an ingredient of paraffin ointment. Okay. And in India, we are using the species Apis indica commonly. So, the common species we are using in India is Apis indica. Keep it in mind. And this is an important aspect. These steps you have to remember. These are important for successful beekeeping. Okay. The first one, the knowledge of the nature and habits of bees. Second one, selection of suitable location. We should locate the beehives near fruiting trees, isn't it? For keeping the beehives. Then catching and hiving of the swarms, the groups. Then fourth one, management of beehives during different seasons. Okay. Then handling and collection of honey and beeswax. And the last one, keeping beehives in crops fields during flowering period to increase pollination efficiency and improve the yield. So it helps to increase the pollination among plants and helps to improve the quality of the yield. Clear? So that's about apiculture. Next, we can move to the topic, the next topic, that is fisheries. You know that fisheries is an industry devoted to catching, processing, selling of fish. Not only fish, other aquatic animals too. Other aquatic plants and animals. Okay. So, while we are discussing about fisheries, don't forget to note the point. Both pisciculture and aquaculture is coming under the branch of fisheries. So, what is the difference between pisciculture and aquaculture? Yes, rearing of fishes are known as pisciculture, but in aquaculture, other aquatic animals like crabs, shrimps, prawn, and other aquatic plants will come. Okay. So, we can start discussion. So, these are some important freshwater fishes. So, freshwater fishes which are commonly used are cutla, rohu, mrigal, common carp, silver carp and grass carp. Okay. And I will show you some marine fishes, hilsha, sardine, mackerel, pomfret. Okay. And different techniques have been applied to increase the production like aquaculture and pisciculture. So, in the case of pisciculture, we can go for both capture fisheries and culture fisheries. Okay. So, for capture fisheries, we can use different types of nets and different types of ships. Okay. And we can use sonar and we can use radar for locating the school of fishes. Okay. Different techniques are there. And in culture fishery too, different techniques are there. Cage method is there. Different types of methods. So, Blue Revolution is implemented in India to increase the fish production. It helps to increase the yield. Okay. So, this table, you should study this table well. So, in this table tells about the difference between pisciculture and aquaculture. We discussed already. Let's just go through that. What is pisciculture? It is a process of growing fish and selling it or using its products either as meat, or we can use byproducts too for domestic or commercial use. Fish can be grown both in salt water or fresh water, and both we can go for both capture fishery and culture fishery. But in aquaculture practice, we are using culture fisheries. In aquaculture, we are using culture fisheries more. Okay. So what is aquaculture? It is a process of growing any aquatic animals and selling them for commercial purpose. It involves feeding, harvesting, and many other processes. The most popular ones grown under controlled environment are shrimps, crabs, fish, lobsters, and few others in tank system. Okay, culture system. Clear? Next topic is plant breeding. What is plant breeding? It is a purposeful manipulation of plant species in order to create desired plant species. Just imagine if you are having two plant varieties, plant A and plant B. Plant A is disease resistant. Plant B is produce enormous number of seeds, but it is not having that much disease resistant power. So if we want to produce a new variety with disease resistance and to produce enormous amount of seeds, we can go for plant breeding techniques. Okay, so to create desired plant species, we are using this technique to create desired plant types that are better suited for cultivation, give better yields, and are disease resistant. Clear? So classical plant breeding involves crossing or hybridization of pure lines followed by artificial selection to produce plants with desirable trait of higher yield, nutrition, and resistance to disease. So we can check the main steps in plant breeding. There are five important steps. The first one is collection. We should have a huge collection of germplasm. Okay, I will show you a diagram. Okay, this is the same as a gene bank. We can collect different varieties. The collection of variability is a collection and preservation of all the different wild varieties, species, and relatives of the cultivated species. So the entire collection having all the diverse alleles of all genes in a given crop. It is termed as germplasm collection. Okay, it's a very important definition, germplasm collection. Okay. Second step, evaluation and selection of parent. Okay. So while we are going for this cross hybridization technique, we should evaluate and we should select parents with desirable combination of characters. Clear? So the selected plants are multiplied and used in the process of hybridization. So in this picture, both conventional breeding technique and genetic modification techniques are there. So you just imagine if a plant with virus resistant capacity and another with a high yield. So we can produce a new hybrid by incorporating the two important characters. Clear? And third one is cross hybridization. Cross hybridization among selected parents to obtain desired crop character. For example, the same example, high protein quality. If a plant is with one plant is with high protein quality and other with disease resistance, we can combine. Okay, this is possible by cross hybridizing the two parents to produce hybrids that genetically combine the desired character in one plant. Clear? So we discussed in lesson 2. Do you remember? And the fourth step, selection and testing. This is very important. We have to select superior recombinants. Okay. So the selection process is crucial to the success of breeding objective and requires careful scientific evaluation of the progeny. We should select the superior recombinant only, because the last step is commercialization. So we have to select the superior recombinants. Clear? So this step yields plant that are superior to both of the parents. Okay. Then the last step, testing, releasing, and commercialization of new cultivars. So the newly selected lines are evaluated for their yield and other agronomic traits of quality, disease resistance, etc. Clear? So these are the five steps which we have to take in care before going for plant breeding, for before hybridization method. Clear? And next we can check some hybrid varieties. Hybrid varieties of wheat and rice. Production of wheat and rice increased tremendously between 1960 and 2000 due to introduction of a semi-dwarf variety, both in the case of rice and wheat. In Kalyan Sona and Sonaliga are wheat varieties, okay, which were high yielding and disease resistant, were introduced all over the wheat growing belt of India. Okay. Then semi-dwarf rice varieties are IR8 and Taichung Native 1. They introduced in 1966. Later, better yielding semi-dwarf varieties like Jaya and Ratna were developed in India. Next one, sugarcane. Two species, Sacharum barberi and Sacharum officinarum, they are the superior parents. They were crossed to get the desirable quality of high yield, thick stem and high sugar content. Okay, they grow and sugarcane areas of North India. It is very important. Then last one, and children in sugarcane breeding institute Coimbatore, they developed different varieties 421 419 205 453 7440. Okay, and the last one, millets. Hybrid maize, jowar and bajri developed in India. These varieties are high yielding and resistant to water stress. Okay, so that is about today's session, and next session we will discuss how to develop how to produce a hybrid with disease resistance and how to produce a variety with pest control, and we will discuss different examples too. Okay, and crops with high protein content, and the last topic is tissue culture and single cell protein that we will discuss in the last session. Okay, so I am sending the same URL that you watched during your first class, but I'll mention the time. Okay, so you just watch the URL and answer the question. Study well. Even though this is a simple lesson, different types of twisted questions, like different examples of different hybrid variety, will come for examination. Okay, so study well. So we can meet in next session.